Raghavan
uncle? Yes. Raghavan. We have with us Sri Raghavan Iyer, who is going to talk about virtuous Krishna. Over to you, Raghavan.
Yeah, good evening. And to all the children. So let me start with the virtuous Krishna. A little song of two lines. I will start with the Sri Krishna song, and at the end you can all sing, you know, the same line. Okay. श्री कृष्ण गोविंद हरे मुरारी हे नाथ नारायण वासुदेवा पितु मात स्वामी सका हमारे हे नाथ नारायण वासुदेवा यू कैन ऑल सिंग नाउ श्री कृष्ण गोविंद कम ऑन लेट्स जॉइन ऑल जॉइन श्री कृष्ण गोविंद हरे मुरारी नाथ नारायण वासुदेवा बोलो श्री कृष्ण की जय
जय
So let's start with the yes. So little song I thought I'll sing before starting. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Let's start with this. What it means, let me just brief you before we go ahead. What is Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya? You must have heard this line, right? These words earlier.
Yes.
Namo.
Yes.
Om refers to the to the Brahmand, to the universe. And Namo. Namo is salutation. Salutation. Namo Bhagavate. Namo is the salutation to the God. And Vasudevaya. What is Vasu? Vasu is life. And Devaya is God. So Vasudevaya means the God, the Supreme God, which gives us the life, the light. So when we say, that means Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, the Supreme God who resides in us. Now that is the most important. What is important to know is the Supreme God who resides in us. Now Krishna says that when we actually chant his name with, you know, the mind, soul and body, that's when he actually, you know, he is listening to us. And he is very much eager, you know, to look at his devotees, and he cares for us. Okay, so that's the gratitude we need to have. I just wanted to brief you on that. How important, you know, Krishna, you know, matters to us, and why he's always thinking of we devotees. Now, coming to the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna talks about the three yogas. Okay, one is the starting with the Karma Yoga, and then you have the Jnana Yoga and Bhakti Yoga. What is Karma Yoga? You have seen it in life. Remember last time when we had the importance of saints in our life? We had discussed about Karma Yoga. Karma is the work we do, right? And Karma Yoga is the selfless service. It is a yoga of selfless work. Second, we have the Jnana Yoga, the yoga of self-knowledge. And third, we have Bhakti Yoga, which is devotion to the God, where we chant God's name. You know, we have seen in Namdev also, the saints. So what happens here is that God says that among all the three, Bhakti Yoga is the highest. It is like three ladders. Like, suppose you are on, you know, you have imagine an elevator having three levels. Okay. So first level, you are at, say, Karma Yoga. Then you go to Jnana Yoga and then the Bhakti Yoga. But here God says that when you do Bhakti Yoga, you are directly on the third level. You are on the highest level. So that is the importance of Bhakti Yoga. So what does he say now? God says that when we do Bhakti, when we chant his name, then we basically develop a devotion for him, a love for him, and he says that this love should be totally pure love. It's like a mother, you know, who is loving his child, her child. What happens here when the mother is, you know, showing the affection and love? Does she expect anything in return?
No, never.
She's always looking at her child, you know, with lot of love and affection. It's a pure love, you know. And that is what God is saying. It should be totally detached love, you know, where you're not thinking of anything. You just want to love the God, and it should be pure love, unconditional love. You don't, you know, pray every day to God and tell him, you know, God, now today you give me this, you know, give me a mobile. Tomorrow I want, you know, very nice car. No. That is not what God is expecting. He says that you just love me and just pray to me with devotion and leave the rest to me. Right? So that is what is the bhakti yoga. So when we do bhakti, we don't expect anything from him. Like a mother, you know, who doesn't expect anything from the child. She always loves him. You know, that's how the love should be. Okay? So God says when you do such a love, then it is absolutely, you know, up to the God to take care of us. You need not bother about anything, about doing well in the exams or, you know, not being scolded by your parents or going out to play. So all those things are taken care, right?
Yeah.
So you get everything at the right time. You don't have to worry. Okay? So that is the beauty of the bhakti yoga, which God is talking about. And as this bhakti develops, you know, what happens? We get closer to God, right? And then the intensity of the love goes on increasing. And that is how the Shraddha comes. Is it not? When we go on chanting, as you go on chanting, you must have seen the last 2-3 months how, you know, you feel so good now. You are so relaxed. Is it not?
Yes.
It is automatically coming. No, Paitrama doesn't have to tell you every day, like, you know, you have to come at 5 p.m., join. No, you are already there, right? So that is how it is. It will come automatically. Because these good things will get instilled in you. Correct? So that's how God takes care of us. Okay? So in the end, what God says, and that is Srimad Bhagavatam is one of the 18 Mahapuranams. Okay? That is a very, very sacred book, this thing, Bhagavatam Puranam, you know. So that is where Sri Krishna says all this. So it is the devotion and it is the love. So devotion is love, and love is the highest quality, highest state of mind which we can share with anybody. Right? So whenever we have any, you know, for example, our parents, then we have our siblings, friends, we should have no expectations. Just distribute the love and leave it like that. Because all friends may not be good to you. Now, one of the beautiful examples I would like to give here is of our gold medalist in the Olympics. Who are the only gold medalist in the Olympics of India? Nobody knows. Javelin throw,
Neeraj Chopra.
Neeraj Chopra. I'll tell you a beautiful example of his great, you know, love for the country. Now, even after winning the gold, he did not feel so proud or something, you know. He said, oh, I did well for India. In fact, I wanted to cross 90 meters. He could do 87. But, you know, what he felt, he said that, you know, his competitor, Jonas Wetter from Germany, who could not finish in the top three also. He, in fact, the earlier day he was saying like, no, Neeraj Chopra cannot win. You know, I will just defeat him and all that. And in spite of that, what Neeraj Chopra said, you know, I would have liked him to win a medal because he's a great javelin thrower. Because he is the only one thrown above 90 meters in the past. But somehow on that day, maybe because of pride or whatever, he just could not do well. You know, because of the rainy track, you know, there was a slip, it was slippery, whatever the conditions. But our Neeraj Chopra could win, you know. And in spite of that, can you believe Neeraj Chopra telling that, you know, I would have loved Jonas better to have won a medal. So that is what we are talking about, you know. We are talking of people because they are all part of the same family. So even in our family, when we have people around us, may not be always, you know, very pleasant, but we have to deal with them with the same love. Is it not? Because we are all, after all, the part of the same, you know, same human group, right? So yes. Please understand this. This is an important part. Now, also now coming to some of the virtues. Now, virtues of Sri Krishna. 2-3, I would like to cover some of them. Virtues, you understand, children, what it means exactly? Virtuous Krishna. What does virtues mean?
Netiquette.
Sorry?
Naughty.
No. Virtues. Virtues is a word which signifies something, you know, which is something very, 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 you know, part of the ethical standards, you can say. It is basically a behavior of high moral standards, which means that, you know, Krishna believed in doing the right things. You know, when last week we remember we had done about Rama, Lord Rama. Rama taught us about righteousness, truth and the right path. But Krishna talks about much more. So we'll start with that. I'll just give you few points which he talked about. To begin with, he talks about calmness of the mind. Now, you know, how can we achieve that standard? You know, how can we reach that virtues? Calmness of the mind. You know, why calmness is required? Why we need the calmness of the mind, you know, so to do anything for that matter, even for your studies? Don't you think if there's a lot of disturbance, how will you concentrate and study? Is it possible?
No,
there's
sir.
A light.
No,
so, yeah.
Sir. No, sir.
Exactly. Sir. Exactly. So this calmness of the mind is the first thing which Sri Krishna talks about. So, what it means, calmness of the mind basically helps the flow of the mind towards God. You know, that's why they say, you know, right in the morning when you get up, you know, we do all the pujas and even studies in the morning, right? At 4 o'clock or 5 o'clock. Why so? Because the mind is very calm. After we sleep and get up, it is easier. We take a bath and then we can sit down for studies or do meditation or do the puja. Correct? So what he talks about is when we want to do prayers or when we want to think about Krishna, then we should have calmness of the mind. So it will, then the mind will easily flow towards Krishna. Okay? So that is the first step he talks about. Secondly, he talks about patience. Now, patience is, you know, very important to bear the burden of the life and that too cheerfully. Now, what is the, why patience is required? Like, you know, many times you see some children, you know, they are very patient, you know, they will not get disturbed. So why it is required? And because patience is something which is a very important quality. Because, you know, we cannot achieve things immediately, you know, things cannot happen. So we need to wait for things to happen. So that is the patience. And over a period of time in life, we have to deal with lot of, you know, challenges, which may not be very easy, you know. So that is why God says that patience is a very important virtue. He says that patience is, you know, helps us to overcome the burden, and we have to do it cheerfully. Right? Now, one example which I will give you, although it is not, may not be exactly patience, but somewhat similar. Patience in the way also signifies that we have faith in God. Because why we are patient? Because we know that things will happen at the right time. Now, there is a beautiful example of, you know, when during the Mahabharata, what happens, that Duryodhana, you know, he instigates Bhishma Pita. Now, Bhishma Pita was a very, very strong, warrior, right? We all know, Ganga Putra. Now, during the war, Duryodhana tells him that, you know, like, you are so, aap itne shoor ho. So, why don't you don't have the guts to kill Arjuna. So then immediately Bhishma announces, you know, in the evening that tomorrow I am going to kill Arjuna. So everybody is very disturbed. And then, but Arjuna is not. Why? I'll tell you why. Now Krishna comes up right in the night at 2 o'clock and wakes up Arjuna and tells him that you must have heard about Bhishma making this announcement, you know, that he's going to kill you tomorrow. But what Arjuna says, Arjuna is not very disturbed. He says that, I don't have to worry, you are there with me. So I don't think, you know, anything will happen. So that's the beauty. So when you have God with you, you won't have to worry. In fact, Duryodhana got the entire army of Krishna, but still Pandavas won. Why? Because they had Krishna on their side. Okay.
And so just
third, yeah.
Dharma.
Sorry.
They also had Dharma on their side because of
that. Yes, exactly. That is why Krishna fought with them, right? Yeah. That is what. Now the third very, very important point is purity. You know, is non-attachment to work. You know, this is a very important concept, although we are a little small to understand, but I think it is very important because from your point of view also, now what does this mean? Purity is non-attachment to work. Now, very important to understand, children, what Sri Krishna is saying here is that we should not, you know, we should do the work, or, you know, when you study, for example, you know, we should not think about the results, the fruits of action. You know, many times it happens, you know, even our innocent parents will tell you, like, you know, you have to, you know, score 95% only, something like that. No, see, that doesn't work. It is all up to you how you actually, you know, study and how well you study. So your objective should be only to study well, not to think about the results. Krishna says that leave the results to me. Because the most important is you should concentrate on the efforts, the right efforts, systematic efforts, sincere efforts. So don't think about the results. Many times, you know, even before the exam is over, you know, many times it happens. We start thinking that, you know, I should get now 95, 9 standard or whatever, whichever standard you have. No, don't think about that. Never do that. Just be prepared well, like Arjuna, how well he prepared himself. Just be prepared well for the exams. Don't get into that, you know, don't get attached to the work. Attached to the work means what, you know, that we tend to only think about what comes out of it. No. In fact, as per Bhagavad Gita, what the saying is, you know, nothing is, you know, we own nothing and nothing owns us. In this world, we are only energy, we are abundance. So here, the important thing is the concept of purity being, you know, non-attachment to work means you just do your work and leave the rest. Never think about the results. That is the unfortunate part. You know, when we always keep thinking about what will happen, then you get into worries, then you are only thinking about the, you know, you get into a lot of issues. Right? So what happens? So purity is non-attachment to work. You just give your best. Again, the example I'll tell you of Neeraj Chopra. On the day, what happened? He was not under any pressure. He said, I'm not going to be under pressure. I'm just going to perform my best and leave the rest. And his first throw was 87 meters. And everybody came under a lot of pressure because 87 meters was too much. And on a slippery track, they just could not, you know, beat him. Right? So this is something very, very important. Please remember that purity is non-attachment to work. Now the fourth important is the greatest gift. You know what is the greatest gift? Is gift of knowledge, which you already got. You are truly blessed. You all are truly blessed. The gift of knowledge is the spiritual knowledge. It is not the worldly knowledge. We are talking of the spiritual knowledge. Knowing God, knowing, you know, what He is doing for all of us, you know, His very presence in our life, you know, how He's taking care of us, and, you know, how we have to be, you know, how we have to remember Him on a day-to-day basis, because He's ultimately, we are the creation of God, is it not? Many people forget it over a period of time. Unfortunately, they even forget who their God, you know, and who is their creator. So, for you, you're all blessed that you're already doing so much of chanting and, you know, following the gods. So, keep continuing to do that. So, that is the greatest gift, which is the gift of knowledge. Right? Then, I'll tell you a couple of things. And learned is he who discriminates between liberation and bondage. Now, what happens is, as I said earlier, that we don't have to be attached to anything. See, here what happens is, if we want to be very happy, then we have to just keep doing your work without, you know, without complaining, without, you know, giving excuses. There'll be work at home, work anywhere. So just keep doing it and just leave the rest. Enjoy it, in fact. Enjoy whatever you're doing, and that is the best way to be free from any kind of problems. Are you getting it? It's as easy as that. You know, like many times you get into different situations. You know, it may not be very easy, but all you have to do is have the patience and be cheerful, and that will take care of you. Right? So these are some of the virtues I would like to discuss, because some of them are a little bit on the higher side. But I'm sure as you go forward, you will learn a lot. And so keep in mind the main part, the devotion to God and the detached love, you know, pure love, like how your mother, you know, cares for you. And that's the way to love God. Okay? Thank you so much. Any other points? Anything you want to say, children? I hope you have got the points.
Yeah, I think, Raghavan, we can have a quick revision, what the students have understood.
Yes.
So you cannot tell the points you have understood. Raise your hands and tell. Whatever you have understood from the life of Krishna, from whatever uncle has said. Yes, Aditya?
Yeah, in words you can tell.
Yes, we should always we should not think about the result before we are doing anything. Actually, we have to think about our work. We just need to think about the result. We first need to think about what we are doing. So automatically we'll get the result.
And accept whatever results come. See, we should not get too disturbed by that. See, results will come as per our efforts. So we don't have to be disturbed, you know, that like, you know, I've got so much. No, it's okay. Just carry on. See, somewhere you will start doing better. It's not like everybody will be, you know, at the same, in the same boat, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
You should be
Others, please mute yourself. Yes, Darshan.
When we need to pray our God, as our mother will take care of our child.
Yes.
We need to pray God like that.
You are loved. Correct. Correct.
Can I tell?
Yes, Himalish.
Yeah, whenever God is with us, we will always win. God and Dharma.
Oh, beautiful.
Yes.
Sanvi?
Yes.
A man should be patient like Krishna.
Patience. Wow. Wonderful. Right. Shrimas?
Yes.
Ma'am, God will only support the Dharma.
Correct. Only if you follow the path of Dharma, God will be with you. Yes.
Yes.
Aditri?
Yes.
We should be calm in every work and do our work fast.
Very good. Yes.
Beautiful.
Sahana? Yes. Very good.
If we chant God's name daily, we go close to God and then Shraddha come.
Very good.
Beautiful. Janvi?
Yes, ma'am. We have to be always virtuous and calm like Krishna, ma'am.
Very good. Yes.
Okay.
Yes, Raghav,
No, that's it. So just follow that. Just enjoy, the prayers which you do to God, and, you know, do it with full Shraddha. That is the main thing. You know, that is how you will, you know, it will ensure that God is listening to us. Is it not? Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, Raghavan.
Yeah.